You're finally ready to take your MCAT. You'll log into the AAMC website and all the seats are gone. Do you pick another date? Do you test somewhere far away, like flying to another state? Actually, no. In this Leah4Sci video, I'm going to show you how you can sign up when you're ready and still get your ideal test date and location. See, for the average student, the thought process goes something like this. I need to take the MCAT, so I'm gonna pick a date that sounds good. Maybe 3 months, 5 months. That should be enough to study, right? Or forget months, I'm gonna pick April, because if I test in April and get my scores in May, I will have an early application. They have to accept me, right? But what if you're not ready? The average student will not be ready for the MCAT in just 3 months, especially if you're studying around work, school, family, and life in general. I've heard advisors say, first sign up for a test date so you have that motivation and pressure to study. That's horrible advice. If you're not ready, you'll start asking yourself, should I just test anyway because I already paid for it? Here's what I recommend instead. Yes, definitely pick your test date, but that's only so you have something to aim for. If this is my test date, this is where I have to be the month before, the month before, the month before, and this way you have a way to evaluate yourself. But if you realize it's not working, you can always postpone or change your date because you've never signed up and you've never paid for anything. And as you keep studying, and as you keep proving to yourself that you are on track, then around 5 or 9 weeks before your MCAT, that is when you want to sign up, because the chances are much higher that when you do sign up now, you don't have to cancel, you don't have to postpone, and you're definitely not making a donation to the AAMC for an exam you're not even taking. But Leah, if I wait that long, all the seats will be gone. If that makes sense, give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and hit that bell notification icon so you don't miss out on any new videos. And let's see how to get around that. Yes, there are the students who sign up, follow a plan, and test on their plan date. But in my experience, more than half the students who pick a test date do not test on that date. You have the student who thinks, yeah, it's so far in advance, of course I'm gonna be ready. But then as they get closer to their test date, they start to panic. They realize they didn't have a plan. They still need so much more time. They drop their test date. You have the student who picked a reasonable test date, had a really good plan, and then life happened. Work became overwhelming. They got sick. Their child got sick. Something derailed their studies. And now they need a little bit more time. They will postpone their test date, and now you have another seat. And let's not forget the, I have no idea if I'm going to be ready, but at least I have a test date student who, when they get closer, again, will postpone or cancel. But Leah, I keep checking and there are still no dates. While dates get dropped at random and it's hard to predict when a seat will open up, there is one thing we can count on, and that is the pre-med student is notorious for waiting till the last minute. And we're going to use this to your advantage. If you look at the AAMC cancellation and rescheduling guidelines, there are two important dates, which I explain in detail link below, and that is 30 days and 60 days. As I record this video, it costs $50 to reschedule your MCAT 60 or more days before your exam, then goes up to $100 30 days prior, and $200 within 10 days of your test date. As I record this video, the AAMC charges $165 to cancel your test date up to 30 days prior to your MCAT. And if you cancel after 30 days, there is no refund. So why is this important? Remember those students waiting for the last minute? When reality sets in and you realize you're not ready, it's a very tough decision. Postponing your MCAT does not make you a failure, but it sure feels like it in the moment. And so the students will go back and forth. Do I test? Can I cram? Should I avoid? What do I do? And the closer they get to the deadline, the more emails I get in my inbox asking for advice. And finally, when there are just a couple of days to go, they figure, I may as well maximize my refund or minimize my fee and that is when the cancellation happens. I am willing to bet that over 50% of postponed or canceled exams happen within the 3 days leading up to that deadline. And that means if you have your sights set on a specific day, that is when you're likely to get a seat. And in the years, of working with pre-meds, I have never had a student who started checking the website 1 week before the deadline not find the seat. What I recommend is that 1 week out from that deadline, start checking the website twice a day. And if you find nothing by 3 days prior, start checking three times a day so that the moment someone cancels, you are right there ready to grab your spot. Now, don't get me wrong. I know that it is going to be a nerve-wracking week and you're probably going to flip-flop between checking for your test date or looking at flights to some crazy far-out location because you just don't believe you're gonna get a spot. But again, I have never had a student do this and not find a test date. Are you the kind of student who would rather know, I have a test date, I don't have to worry about it, and if I have to postpone, I will? Or would you rather try something like this, deal with a little bit of panic, but know that you only have to sign up once? Let me know in the comments below.